The new Doctor Who Redacted audio series has launched in the last couple of weeks. Produced by BBC Studios, it's a 10-part weekly series that follows an ensemble cast exploring new adventures in the Doctor Who universe. Thankfully, we've got a ton of Easter eggs that feature in the new audio drama that Doctor Who fans are going to find really interesting. So let's explore what we found out. Welcome to Tardis Central, I'm your host Jack, and let's get straight into it. Almost at the halfway point of its run, the BBC Sounds produced radio play, Doctor Who Redacted, has been in full swing. Though centered on three new characters, Cleo Proctor, Abby McPhail, and Shauna Thompson, the podcast series has been filled with some lovely references to other episodes of Doctor Who, and even the wider Whoniverse. Today we're going to be kicking off a look at these lovely referential Easter eggs, with a roundup of the first episode of the series, SOS. If you do want to keep up to date on all the latest Doctor Who news, lore and more, then make sure to hit that subscribe button to never miss a video from the team here at TARDIS Central. You can of course follow us on social media for daily updates on the Doctor Who universe. The first Easter egg of the series comes in the form of one of the tales told in the podcast recording by Abby. For those who don't know, Abby's mention of a group of people that sign up to a pilot trial of a weight loss pill from Adipose Industries is a direct reference to the new fourth series episode Partners in Crime. In the series opening episode, Donna Noble, inspired by her previous encounter with the Doctor, has been investigating the Adipose company. Ultimately, she came to reunite with the 10th Doctor, and discovered that the company was a front for its manager, Miss Foster. Miss Foster had been distributing the pills to biologically alter the fat of humans into baby adipose, as a part of her contract with the Adiposean First Family. Usually a covert and harmless process, distraught by the interference of the Doctor and Donna. Miss Foster sped up the creation of the adipose using an inducer built into the company building. As the first episode of Redacted points out, this speed up resulted in people being ultimately converted into adipose, effectively dying. Though the Doctor and Donna were ultimately able to stop the inducer and stop the process from killing many more people. It seems based on this episode that these murders have been quickly and publicly explained in a far more ordinary way. It's believed to be a horrific accident with untested and unregulated tablets. Though people who experienced the process themselves and have survived would tell people what really had actually happened. That must have been a weird story. Penny Carter, who later makes an appearance in this opening episode Redacted, was also in Partners in Crime. Though her investigations into the company were more noticeable, and she did get a bit tied up. Abby also mentions that during these events, the blue box, in fact the TARDIS of course, was spotted at least 5 times. Now, Abby and Cleo's excited mentioning of a podcast also features crop circles, Area 51, and an alien fetus in a jar. This also may be coy reference to New Who's 6th season, during which the episode Day of the Moon shows the 11th Doctor being contained within Area 51, as a part of a careful plan. The episode A Good Man Goes to War features a flesh replicant of the Baby River Song, being transported in a small pod. The story Let's Kill Hitler features the use of crop circle messages to get the Doctor's attention. Later on in this episode of Redacted, when discussing who should meet with Penny, Cleo says, "When you sent me there that Yeti person, I deleted the whole thing." This is likely a reference to the classic Who story, The Web of Fear, from Season 5. As well as featuring the second on-screen appearance of a robotic Yeti, the story also had a reputation it was missing from the BBC archives for over 4 decades. With the archives having destroyed their copy of the episode back in the early 1970s, to make space and save money and time before home media and repeats were a thing, it might seem like they may stay deleted forever. Thankfully, 5 of the story's 6 episodes have been recovered, restored, and released for fans to watch, though one episode still remains elusive to this day. Whilst out in a cafe, Abby hears a news report stating that South Yorkshire Police have issued a renewed appeal for information on the disappearance of Sheffield's residents, Graham O'Brien and Ryan Sinclair. This of course refers to the two most recently departed companions, Graham and Ryan. They both traveled with the 13th Doctor through Series 11 and Series 12, ultimately deciding in Revolution of the Daleks to leave their travelling and spend time together on Earth in the 2020s. Both content on doing so, having had so many great adventures. It's understandable they have been both caught up in the events of Redacted. Reference is also made to the Series 2 story, Love and Monsters. As Sean also questions if Penny Carter is perhaps another blue box fruitcake from Linda. In that story, Linda, short for London Investigation and Detective Agency, was a small society formed in the late 2000s by people dedicated to finding out more about the Doctor. However, over time, Linda became more of a social club for those involved, as they all became more connected with each other and more engaged in other matters in their own personal lives. Suddenly overtaken by the malicious Victor Kennedy, actually an Zorbaloff, who had his own malicious reasons for wanting to find the Doctor, almost all of the members of Linda were absorbed by him over a short period of time before the Doctor eventually showed up and dealt with him. If Redacted has anything to go by, it seems that the sole survivor, Elton Pope, has kept the group going since then. Finally, the episode ends with a surprising return of Rani Chandra. Rani debuted in the second series of the spin-off TV show, The Sarah Jane Adventures. As a teenager, she had moved into the same street as Sarah Jane, Bannerman Road. As a former companion to the Doctor, Sarah Jane and her friends had been combating alien menaces and protecting the Earth for some time when Rani arrived. Almost as soon as she arrived, Rani found herself caught up in Sarah Jane's adventures. Initially surprised, but eventually very happy to help Sarah Jane and the others. Following the show's later indications that Rani was interested in journalism, appearances of the character have been since established, but she's had quite a career as a journalist since leaving Bannerman Road and the passing of Sarah Jane Smith. So there we have it, quite an opening episode packed with a lot of references. Did you know all of these, or were there any that surprised you? Or do you think we perhaps missed something? We'd love to hear your thoughts in the comments section below. If you do want to keep up to date on all the latest Doctor Who news, lore and more, then make sure to hit that subscribe button to never miss a video from the team here at TARDIS Central. You can also follow us on social media and we look forward to engaging with you. For now, I've been Jack, thanks for watching, and provided we don't get redacted from reality, we'll see you next time.